know, I was supposed to go to the collection, I never did, because it's just the time that's coming up. So I've been doing all sorts of things. I got the phone.
Are you sitting home? Are you on there?
Grandpa.
Grandpa. Anybody can have a body that big. My mother.
Just don't give up. Good afternoon. What a glorious weekend we have to gather together and to celebrate the most astonishing weekend the world ever experienced. We started out yesterday with a Good Friday service to remind ourselves that Good Friday was good for us, really hard and painful for Jesus Christ. And we live in a world today that is torn apart by conflict, wars and rumors of wars, famine, all the things going on in the world around us. And it all stems from the reality that the world, by and large, has a hard time recognizing and celebrating the death of Jesus on the cross on Good Friday. And today, Saturday, Jesus is in the womb, is in the tomb. He's resting. His agony on the cross is done. The disciples are in disarray. Now, you and I, we can look back in history and we see that, yes, there was darkness on Friday, but Sunday was coming. They could not. So we have a unique place today. Here we are in 2024. And the choir has been working very, very hard to prepare musically the story of the gospel and all it means to each one of us. So I'm glad that you're here today. I'm glad that you've chosen to celebrate with us and to take advantage of the hard work that the choir has put into this for weeks now. So the Apostle Peter writes these words, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to His great mercy, He has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by God's power are being guarded through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time." This living hope, that's what we're here to celebrate today, celebrating all that the resurrection of Jesus Christ means to us and for us. So this afternoon, join us and celebrate with us. I read it. What was that, Betty?
You have a narration before we start.
I did it. However, that gives us a wonderful pause to pray. Can we do that? Father, thank you for your goodness. Jesus, we're here to celebrate you and all that you did for us. We want you to be pleased and blessed through this music. Speak to each one of us through the voices of this choir. And we pray that today our hearts will be united in worship towards you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
We come together today to remember the greatest act of sacrificial love the world will ever know. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. The Jewish nation longed for and expected a powerful conquering king. Instead, they were presented with a gentle and humble shepherd teacher, a loving servant who changed lives one at a time. He laid aside his heavenly crown to come to earth and take his place as a humble servant. During his 3 years of earthly ministry, Jesus reminded people of a kingdom that was eternal, not political, not worldly. He made disciples of those who listened and enemies of those who were in power, as well as disappointed those longing for deliverance from Rome. As Jesus prepared to enter Jerusalem for the last time, the streets were crowded with palm branches and impassioned cries. Hosanna! He comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King. Those shouting surely did not understand all that was happening that day. But the Father was not going to let his son come through the gates unnoticed. Soon the hosannas would fade away and the palm branches discarded along the road, with few realizing this celebration was actually the beginning of Jesus' resolute journey to the cross. The religious and political leaders were plotting in secret to find ways to prevent Jesus from diluting their power and control over the people. Their verdict and plotting declared that Jesus must die. As the sun began to set on the night before his execution, Jesus called his chosen to a dimly lit upper room. They made their way through the dark streets, bracing against the cold wind and the storm about to come. And as the meal ended, Jesus prayed, saying, "Father, the time has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son may glorify you." Then once again, the group made their way through the darkened streets toward a deserted garden called Gethsemane, where another heartfelt prayer would be offered up. Thank you. May your will be done. And with these words to his father and an exhortation to his followers to pray for themselves, Jesus faced into the storm. He was brutally arrested, subjected to a mockery of trials, and the King of creation was forced to wear a crown of cruel thorns while those mocking him cried out, "Hail, King of the Jews!" Beaten nearly to death, he was forced to carry his wooden cross and walk the road that was meant for you and me. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was pierced through for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him the chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed. Jesus was nailed upon the cross at the third hour. It was the sixth hour when darkness fell upon the earth, and the ninth hour when Jesus cried out, "It is finished," and breathed his last. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power, honor, glory, and praise forever and ever. The Apostle Paul writes, "But now the righteousness of God has been manifested apart from the law, although the law and the prophets bear witness to it. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God and are justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a propitiation or payment by his blood, to be received by faith. This was to show God's righteousness at the present time, so that he might be just and the justifier of the one who has faith in Jesus. Yes, it was our sin that placed Jesus on the cross. His pain and his suffering should have been ours."
Father, forgive them, I heard you faintly say. Still in my heart I feel so guilty. I know the truth is the debt was mine to pay. So how could it be right that it happened this way? A fallen and sinful life I was leading. Now why is it your body that is bleeding? It should have been my hands where the nails were. It should have been my feet where the nails were. It should have been my side that was opened, my heart that was broken. It should have been my It should have been my feet where the nails were.
The disciples of Jesus scattered in fear. Jesus was taken down from the cross and placed in the cold silence of a borrowed tomb. A large stone was rolled over the tomb's door and sealed by the authorities. All seemed lost, and the cause of Christ defeated. But on the third day, in the hushed shadows just before dawn, something began to happen that would change the meaning of death and life forever.
The clouds had not yet lifted. The tomb was sealed in dark. The cruel cross had crucified the hope of every heart. The Son of God, the Lord of life, by death had been destroyed. Then in the silence of the tomb, he heard his Father's voice. Arise, arise, first star of the morning skies. Come forth, my anointed one, into eternal life. Arise, arise, disguise, my glorious Son, victorious one in majesty. Arise. The earth began to tremble, the earth began to quake. The mighty stone that sealed the tomb of death began to shake. And suddenly, in darkness, was shattered by the light. And Jesus Christ, the Son of God, comes to the door of life. Arise, arise, first star of the morning skies, come forth, my anointed one, into eternal life. Arise, arise, cast away death's dark disguise, my glorious Son, victorious one, in majesty. Arise, come forth, my anointed one, into eternal life. Arise, arise, cast away death's dark disguise, my glorious Son, victorious one, in majesty. Arise, arise, arise.
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to his great mercy, he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. This risen Jesus endured the cross and gave himself for us. So we crown him with praise because of all he has done for us. When we were at our worst, he gave his best. So we may join the angels and crown him with praise. Jesus, we choose to kneel before you today and crown you Lord of our lives. It is through your death and resurrection that we can stand redeemed before your throne, trusting in your work on the cross for our salvation. We do not deserve such mercy, but we thank and praise you for such unconditional grace. And Jesus, we so look forward to the day when you return and call us home, where you have prepared a place for us to be with you forever. When we see you, we want to say with the Apostle Paul, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all who have loved his appearing. Lord Jesus, we look forward to the day when all shall rise and crown you King. Even so, Lord Jesus, come, come quickly.
Was a holy hush all over as I walked into the room. And as I stood before him face to face, I was gloriously made new. There was a great and awesome presence and a light as bright as any day. And as I bowed to kneel with the angels, I heard the Spirit say, of the Holy One. Arise, arise, as we worship the Messiah. Arise. Then I looked at those around me with their lifted high, and the Spirit laid his hands on me, and I uplifted mine, and we were singing hallelujah and praises to his name. And as I kneeled to bow with the angels, I heard the Spirit say, as they stand before them.
Awesome. Just be seated just for a moment. We want to say welcome and all to our live stream audience, and for those that are visiting with us, you can go to our website at htcfsurprise.org or our YouTube channel, Happy Trails Christian Fellowship, and you can see a recording in about an hour and a half of our service this evening, this afternoon. And we want to thank you, all those hardworking people who put all the images up on the screen and the sound technology. Thank you very much. The Apostle John wrote the last gospel, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. He ended toward the end of the gospel in chapter 20, the last two verses of chapter 20, John writes this: "Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of the disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life in his name." If you are here this afternoon and inside of you, you know you do not have that life. You do not have that spiritual life inside where the real you resides. The choir this afternoon has given us the message from start to finish, but all of Scripture, from Genesis to Revelation, is about this amazing thing that God has done in purchasing our salvation through the ransomed life of His Son hanging on the cross. We don't deserve that mercy. We don't deserve that grace. It is a gift. You can't earn it. Can't go to church to get it. Can't give enough money. Can't do enough good deeds. It's only by faith in the work of Jesus Christ on the cross. We here today pray that you have that assurance, that you have trusted Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone for your salvation. Today, we live in an uncertain world, but with God, you can be so certain of your future, to live with Him forever. We trust that you have that assurance. Thank you, choir, for your hard work. Thank all of you for coming. If you have no place to attend, you're welcome to join us for our Easter service at 9:13 tomorrow morning. Well, we'll all be back in here to celebrate even further the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you again, choir. Thank you for all your hard work. Let's give them a hand for it. Amen. God bless you. Have a great evening. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Good, good. Wasn't that fun?
Oh, it's good to be here.
Good. Good, good. Good. God bless you.
If you didn't feel the spirit there, I don't know.
You bet. You bet. Yeah, you bet.
Thank you, sir.